The cold room, according to the Minister of Health, has the capacity to hold 10,000 liters of vaccines. It will serve the districts of Kabarore, Kamwenje, Chitagwenda, Chenjojo, Chegegwa, Fort Poto, Bunyangabu, Kasese, Ntoroko, and Bundibujo.
And it's capable of serving the whole region in the Greater Rwenzori region of Toro Kingdom. And it's going to be a service point, and it carries vaccines between 2 degrees to 8 degrees.
The facility was launched by the State Minister for Primary Healthcare, Margaret Muhanga. Muhanga said the facility will save the locals from walking long distances to get services. The minister also used the opportunity to lash out at what she described as prophets of doom that are discouraging the locals from taking vaccinations.
People who are called prophets of doom, they have a lot of stories about vaccines. They have a lot of vaccine apathy. They discourage people. You saw this with Ebola, people were running to witch doctors and here they wouldn't help, and the witch doctors and their families died as well. So we discourage people from listening to prophets of doom. They should listen to medical workers.
Late last year, Kabarore District Health Office revealed that their campaign on vaccination was being sabotaged by prophets who were encouraging parents not to take their children for vaccination and declaring vaccines dangerous.
They should listen to professionals. They should learn to respect professionals, because they've run to those people and they've never had help. So they still come here for treatment, and sometimes they come when it's too late and not after they have even given other people the disease.
Dr. Alex Adaku, the Fort Poto Regional Referral Hospital Director, praised the Minister of Health for the initiative, saying this will help the facility meet their targets on vaccination without any hindrances.
The vaccine for malaria, then all these vaccine preventable diseases will come to pass in our place. We no longer have the measles wards which we used to know.
Report compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.